Hello, I'm Juliana. I'm working on NXP for almost 8 years. And in the last two, I've been part of the Linux security team working on CAM driver, the NXP module for crypto acceleration. Today, I'll talk about CryptoEngine, a framework I've discovered while working on dencrypt and backlogging support for CAM. During the talk, I'll cover this content. What is CryptoEngine and what it can be used for, how can it be used, and we'll talk about its API. I'll present you the improvements I've added to the framework and what performance we gain by using the new features, how a driver can be updated to include these improvements. Next, we'll discuss some ideas for enhancement, and at the end, we'll draw some conclusions. For what is CryptoEngine, I'll start by telling you one of its use cases. I found out about CryptoEngine while adding support for dencrypt in CAM driver. In crypto layer, the block cipher hardware engine driver fetches requests from dencrypt into its queue to wait for its thread or word queue to handle and finalize the request when finishing the encryption or decryption. However, the old method needed each hardware engine driver to implement and maintain their own queue and thread for processing requests. Linaro introduced in 2016 CryptoEngine framework that implements the queue and thread for pushing requests to the hardware as the hardware becomes free so that drivers could use it. At the same time, it can avoid some reduplicated code in hardware engine driver. So CryptoEngine, it's a queue manager. It manages asynchronous requests in form of crypto async request. It supports SK cipher, AK cipher, AAD, and hash request. More important, CryptoEngine manages all crypto transformations that request backlogging. That means they have the crypto TFM break you may backlog flag set. The purpose of may backlog is to make the crypto request reliable. Without the backlog flag, if the hardware queue is full, the request will simply be dropped, which is appropriate in the network case with IPsec, for example. Block layer, on the other hand, should always use the backlog flag and stop sending more requests to the crypto API until the congestion goes away. So CryptoEngine queue the request for later execution, it doesn't drop it. It also keeps the order of the request. This is one important aspect for dencrypt with for the dencrypt use case. In kernel, there are already a lot of drivers that use CryptoEngine, and here is a list of these drivers. Next, we'll talk about how to use CryptoEngine, and we'll discuss its API. As I've mentioned, CryptoEngine is a queue manager, has its own queue. So first, remove any request queue and the thread or word queue or taslet, which is used to queue request in the driver. CryptoEngine only manages crypto async request, but we can retrieve the original request by using container off. Also, CryptoEngine has specific function for each of these async requests, as we'll see later on. There are two structures in CryptoEngine that each driver must include. We have the CryptoEngine, which must be added in a device descriptor structure. Here, there are some callbacks that the driver can provide. We have prepare crypt hardware to prepare the hardware when it becomes active, and prepare crypt hardware function to disable the hardware when there are no requests to do. And the do batch request callback, we'll see later what this callback can be used for. And I think that its name, it says it all, actually. Next structure is the CryptoEngine context, as we see here, which must be added in the crypto transformation context. This has some CryptoEngine operation. We have a prepare request if the driver needs to do some preparation before handling the current request, and undo it by setting up prepare request when finalizing one request. Drivers must provide a function to each request by setting do one request. So this last callback, do one request, is mandatory. In the next couple of slides, I'll show you how CAM driver integrates with CryptoEngine framework. And from now on, we'll highlight the driver code with blue, and orange will be used for CryptoEngine code. First, we'll talk about how the needed structure were declared and initialized, and then we'll go through the execution flow. So first, we add a crypto engine to driver's private data. Next, we call a crypto engine alloc init function to initialize and allocate the engine. After the initialization of crypto engine, we can start it by calling crypto engine start. If there are any problems or errors during queuing request, we can stop the engine by calling crypto engine stop or remove it with crypto engine exit, as we have here in CAM driver. The crypto engine exit function from crypto engine API, first it calls the stop function and then removes it. Next, in order to be able to send requests to crypto engine, we need to have a crypto engine context structure. This must be added as the first member of the transformation context. It must be the first member because crypto engine only manages async requests. It cannot know the underlying request type and thus only has access to the transform structure. It is not possible to access the context using container auth. In addition, the engine knows nothing about the transformation context structure from the driver. Therefore, the engine assumes and actually it requires the placement of the known member crypto engine at the beginning. Before transferring any request, we have to fill the crypto engine operation. We have to fill this crypto engine context by providing functions for prepare, unprepare request, and do one request. As I've mentioned, the last one is mandatory. So in CAM, we only register do one request. As you can see here, we have SKSI for do one request. The other prepare and unprepare requests are already implemented in the encrypt decrypt callbacks or finalize callbacks. This is the execution flow for a crypto request with crypto engine. When a driver receives a crypto request via encrypt decrypt callbacks, we have to transfer it to crypto engine, which adds it in engine queue. Then crypto engine starts pumping requests by calling do one request callback from driver, which submits the request for execution to hardware accelerator. Now we wait for completion, and when one request has finished encrypting or decrypting, the finalized done or done callback from driver is called, and we call the finalized crypto finalized request function from the crypto engine API. In the next couple of slides, we'll go through this execution flow with CAM driver samples on how to call the crypto engine API. We'll use as example SKSI for request, and in encrypt decrypt callback, this is the SKSI for crypt in CAM case. We transfer the request to crypto engine by calling the crypto transfer SKSI for request to engine. This goes in crypto engine and calls the generic crypto transform request, which will enqueue the request in its queue. As we can see here, we have crypto enqueue request. Then the main execution loop starts in crypto engine, that is a crypto pump request. Here, a request is removed from a crypto engine queue. We call here crypto DQ request, and this will call the do one request callback from the driver. This goes into the driver callback. We have in CAM SKSI for do one request, which sends the request to hardware for execution. We call CAM jobring enqueue. When the request has finished its execution on hardware, the done callback, SKSI for crypt done, is called in the driver. And this will call the completion of the request from crypto engine. That means it will call crypto finalize SKSI for request and goes in the generic crypto engine finalize request, which marks the request as complete, as we can see here. Now, before talking about and explaining the improvements I added to Crypto Engine, let me tell you about some problems I found while exploring Crypto Engine. When trying to add backlogging support to CAM, I've made the performance measurement on Crypto Engine. I realized that the framework is sending requests to hardware one by one. It uses a current request variable, which keeps the request in execution and is not sending a new one until this is made null on finalize. So CryptoEngine, it was serializing execution, even if the hardware has support for multiple requests. Also, as I've mentioned, CryptoEngine accepts only async requests. So any other non-API request that the hardware is capable of doing, like split key or RNG, these are some examples from CAN driver case, these cannot be sent via CryptoEngine. These will be still sent, but directly to hardware. So there were cases when CryptoEngine sends a request for execution and from driver, a non-crypto API request was sent to hardware, and the CryptoEngine request will return error even if that request had the main backlog flag set. Also, the CryptoEngine queue size was hard-coded to 10 entries for regular requests. If the queue reached the 10 entries, the non-backlog requests were dropped, even if the hardware could execute them in case it has multiple entries than the CryptoEngine queue. For example, CAM can execute up to 512 requests. For all these problems, I found the solutions. I added a retry mechanism to be able to requeue a request if the hardware cannot execute it at that specific moment. Using this retry mechanism, we can send multiple requests for execution. Actually, we can send requests until the hardware says it's full. In that case, when the hardware returns full, we stop and CryptoEngine will restart pumping requests when hardware becomes available, meaning when a finalized request is executed. Some hardware accelerators have support for executing multiple linked requests at once. I added support for this use case, but it's experimental. I couldn't test it. I don't have any hardware with the batch support. Also, the CryptoEngine queue size is not hard-coded anymore. It can be set when CryptoEngine structure is initialized. It can be set with a value based mainly on hardware capabilities. Now, this is the old execution flow of CryptoEngine, which was sequential. When a second request was transferred to CryptoEngine, it was enqueued. And on the main loop, before sending it to hardware for execution, the previous request was checked. Recall the current requeue variable I've mentioned before. If this request is still in progress, the second request is not sent to hardware anymore. The CryptoEngine exits and wait for the first request to finish. Now, this is the new execution flow of CryptoEngine. It sends requests to hardware for execution until the hardware queue is full. If the hardware has support for a retry mechanism, the request is put back in front of the CryptoEngine queue to keep the order of request. So if the hardware queue is full, we requeue the request regardless of main backlog flag. For backwards compatibility, the retry support if the retry support is not available, the CryptoEngine will work as before. If at the beginning I showed you how to use CryptoEngine and how to integrate its API into a driver, let's see what changes are necessary to use the new features. First, we'll need to use the new CryptoEngine alloc init and set function. This initializes CryptoEngine and also sets the CryptoEngine queue size, as we can see here. This is not hard-coded anymore in CryptoEngine. This can be set in the driver. As this example here from CAM driver, we set the CryptoEngine max queue length to a number based on the hardware capabilities, based on the job ring entries. The new crypto alloc init and set function also sets the retry support variable. This was added for backwards compatibility. By default, the retry support is false and the CryptoEngine will work as before. We'll send requests to hardware one by one on crypto pump request and complete the request on crypto finalize request and so on. To support multiple requests in each driver, the retry support must be set on true, as we have here in CAM. This will send requests to hardware until full. If do one request as we can see here, returns an error, the driver must not free the request, since this will be enqueued back into CryptoEngine queue. We call here CryptoEngine request head. We put it in front of the queue to keep the order of request. When all drivers will support the new retry mechanism, I think we can remove this retry support variable. Before a commit in 2017, the Crypto API was using BZ return value to indicate both a hard failure to submit a crypto operation to a hardware accelerator when the latter was busy and the backlog mechanism was not enabled, as well as a notification that the operation was queued into a backlog when the backlog mechanism was enabled. So having the same return code indicate two very different conditions depending on a flag was both error prone and required extra runtime check. Therefore, the return code they used to indicate a crypto request failed due to hardware being busy was changed to no space in Crypto API. The same should be done in each driver. In CAM, here we return no space in case the hardware queue, that is the job ring, is full. Now in CryptoEngine, if hardware queue is full, we return no space. The request is enqueued regardless of the made backlog flag. If hardware throws any other error like IO or invalid, these are fatal errors, it cannot be recovered from. And in this case, the CryptoEngine exits. For example, in CAM driver, we use IO to in case the job descriptor is broken, so there is no possibility to fix the job descriptor. This is a fatal error, so we shouldn't requeue the request. If we do this, the request will just be passed back and forth between CryptoEngine and hardware. The new callback do batch request executes a batch of requests, as its name says. This has the CryptoEngine request as argument, as we can see here, for cases when more than one CryptoEngine is used. The CryptoEngine alloc init and set function initializes CryptoEngine, but also sets the do batch request callback. On a CryptoPump request, if do batch request callback is implemented in a driver, this will be executed. The link between the request will be done in driver if possible. Do batch request is available only if the hardware has support for multiple requests. We can see this here. As I previously mentioned, this is experimental and I didn't test it so far. Now let's look on the performance results on CryptoEngine usage before and after adding the new feature, the retry mechanism. Since my work with CryptoEngine started while adding support for backlogging in CAM, the first results are for dencrypt. I set up an encrypted partition with the crypt setup for dencrypt and created files with different sizes on an IOWN6 Q subreport. I used, as you can see here, the DD to create files. Maybe it's not the most precise tool for performance testing, although I used the fdatasync to be sure that the data is physically written to the file before finishing. We have here the speed in megabytes per second, and on the X we have the file sizes also in megabytes. Higher is better, so it's clearly the CryptoEngine, the new CryptoEngine flow is better than the old one. We have here almost double the speed for small file sizes, and here we have 70% to 60% to 70% increase for 4 giga or 2 gigabytes of data. Next, I use TCrypt speed test. I wanted to have an in-kernel test, no user space to kernel space transition overhead. TCrypt is the crypto testing module intended for self-testing algorithm implementations. Here we have the result for AES CBC with 128-bit key size run on the same IOWN6Q subreport. The speed is in megabits per second, and here we have the chunks of data sent for execution. As it can be seen, we have big, very big differences for small chunks of data. Here are like 600-700% increase. And for very big chunks of data, we have a 50% increase here or 100% increase here for 4K. The same T-Crit speed test I've run on an iDotMX 8, which has a newer version of CAM module than the iDotMX 6. Here we also have better results with the new version of CryptoEngine. For small chunks of data, we have 200% higher speed for small chunks of data, and 10 to 20% increase for big chunks of data. Even though we have clearly better performance with the new CryptoEngine, we still need to further investigate why some performance results are not as expected. Why do we have such a big difference between targets? 50% gain on an iDotMX 6 and 7%, 10% gain on an iDotMX 8. Also, a big difference between chunks of data. We have 200% increase on 256 bytes of data and 10% increase for 16 kilobytes of data. Also, I believe we can still extend and enhance CryptoEngine. We can add support for other than async requests. As I've mentioned during this talk, there are drivers which has non-crypto API requests like RNG in CAM or a split key, which are not accepted by CryptoEngine right now. So the drivers need to have two paths, one to transfer the request to CryptoEngine and another one to submit the request directly to hardware. For performance increase, I believe we can try to remove some locks used now for all three major operations of CryptoEngine: transfer, submit request, and finalize. But this, I think, will need more time to investigate and a thorough testing. To conclude this talk, I believe it's fair to say that CryptoEngine is easy to use, and the new feature adds performance up to 500% higher speed for some use cases. CryptoEngine is definitely the de facto queuing mechanism for backlogging requests, and not only. CryptoEngine can be used in multiple applications if a driver wants to support disk encryption or file system encryption for DM integrity checker of block devices, and the list can go on. Also, Herbert, the CryptoEngine, the crypto maintainer, the crypto subsystem maintainer, said in one of his reviews that CryptoEngine is the queuing mechanism that any crypto driver can use to implement the queuing. That's all for me. Thank you. And if you have further questions, let me know.